Do not shoot straight at the sun, and stay tuned to learn why. It's been 8 years that I've been shooting and always shooting against the sun. Really loved it, but never really understood why I could never bring back the contrast in my images. And I'm gonna be real with you guys. I've just recently really noticed that and what I was doing wrong. Like I said, I kept shooting straight at the sun. Now, this really just shifted my perspective, and I'm not trying to say you should never do it or it is completely wrong, but let's get into that. Now let's start with haze. Now I love haze. I think it can make an image look very soft, very angelic, and I think it works very well in couples, kids, kind of family. It really gives that kind of like love to the actual image. It's like a weird feeling you get from seeing a little bit of haze in there. But to be honest, you want to at least get a couple shots without any form of hazing so you actually get that sharp image. Sometimes that's what the client actually wants. And if you don't know what you're doing to continue to get that haze, then this is definitely something we have to work in. I recently did a photo shoot for some family members, and in the middle of the photo shoot, I realized I couldn't get away from this haze as long as I was pointing my camera straight to the sun. Now, of course, there's ways to go around this. You move your subject a little bit away from the sun, or you kind of get the angle away from the sun, and you'll definitely start to cut that haze. But you have to be aware of when your image is hazing, because sometimes, especially if you're shooting with the cheaper lens, you will not be able to bring any contrast back into that image. So keep that in mind. Keep that in mind on your next photo shoot, that you at least got an image that is very clear, it's sharp, zero haze in the actual image. Now, the second reason why I think you should stay away from the sun, for the most part, unless you are being intentional. That's kind of like the key phrase here, because shooting towards the sun can look great if that's the look you're going for and your clients want that in their images. But flares can sometimes be really ugly and in the wrong place of your image. And you cannot fix the flare once it's baked into the actual photo. But you know, the same goes for video. You cannot fix that in post. I mean, maybe you could, but it would be hours of Photoshop, and you know you don't want to fix anything in post. Now, again, a great way to cut the flare is to be using a lens hood, and like I mentioned, stay away from pointing the lens straight at the sun. Now, here's a great example that I shot that I actually really like this image, and the flare, I don't know how I feel about it, but it is very big in this image, and there's no way to Photoshop that. That would take hours, if any, you know, to really get the colors back to where they should be. But this is one of those examples where I feel like it fits because it's a family photo, and flares just kind of give it that kind of warmer, kind of hazy tone to the actual image that I feel like it kind of adds to the whole family love. That's the vibe, at least, that I get from this. And the people in the photo really liked it, so it worked out well. Now, if you've ever done any form of photos where the camera is pointing again towards the sun, you know that these cameras have the hardest time to figure out what is even in the image in order to focus it. They will just be focus hunting all over the place, and it's gonna be a nightmare, especially if you're in a position of a wedding or, of course, shooting professionally, getting paid for it, and people are wondering why you haven't changed the pose in the last 5 minutes. You do not want to fumble through all that stuff. So remember, if your camera is pointing straight at the sun, it will have a really hard time to focus and find the eyes if you're using IAF, or the face if that's the way you're going for. So remember, it's not the camera, because I've been there where I'm like, what is wrong with this camera? It will not focus on my subject. But there went again, the sun right in the middle of the photo, and really shining way too bright into the sensor to where the camera couldn't find a single thing to focus on. So keep that in mind. Now, in conclusion, was the title clickbait? Not necessarily, because I seriously hated shooting towards the sun on this day and having a harder time to find the zero haze in the images that I was actually trying to get. So I felt like this was a perfect time for me to jump on here and kind of explain this, because I knew I didn't really understand how I was getting so much haze, how I was getting too many flares, and why my camera wasn't focusing. And all of this was getting caused because I was pointing my camera straight at the sun. And to kind of backtrack a little bit, I really started to notice this once I was actually shooting video in a closed environment and there were some lights kind of hitting the lens and we were getting flares into the lens. But obviously in video, we use a matte box, which is basically a sun hood that just goes right above the camera lens in order to kind of block any light that's spilling and hitting the lens, therefore creating a softer image. So that really kind of got the gears turning on. Hold up, I didn't really pay attention to this when I'm taking photos out and about. So yeah, turns out that's why I couldn't bring back the contrast. I've been shooting for a while. For the most part, I'm self-taught, and this is just to kind of show you guys, you know, I definitely don't know everything. I'm sure you guys have noticed that, but I feel like we are all learning as we go, especially as new cameras and new forms of focusing and all these things come out. There's just so many things to continue to learn. Yeah, that's all I really have for you guys today. If you guys liked this video, make sure you like it. If not, well, thanks for watching. Appreciate it. And I'll see you guys on the next video if you do come by. Yeah. See you.